I'm a ghost. Yummy. Hello everyone, it's Emma. Welcome back to my channel. I hope you're all doing well. For today's video, I'm going to be doing a how-to video. I haven't had many requests for this video, but recently I've been doing a hairstyle that I've really been loving, and I thought it would be really fun to share it with you guys. The how-to video that I'm going to be doing is how to do a messy bun. So recently when I've been getting home from school, I've been doing a messy bun in my hair, obviously, and it's been really comfortable, really quite pretty, quite sassy, elegant, well not really elegant, so it's like a classy, like a mix between a casual, classy, elegant, so it's quite, so a lot of people do it, so it kind of makes it quite, I don't know the word, but like quite in the trends, I guess. Messy buns have been around for a long time now. I have only just, discovered them, but when I was like younger, like 10, 11, I was like, ew, this is what the ugly, like ugly teenagers, sorry. I didn't mean to say that, but this is like kind of what the cool girls wear, and back then I didn't think I was cool at all. I still don't think I'm cool, I just think I'm a lot more confident and like hang around a bit more, like say hang out and stuff, but that's just my opinion. But yeah, I'm going to be showing you how to do a messy bun. So right here I have all of the equipment you'll be needing. You will be needing for this tutorial, or if you are going to be trying this at home, a hairband. Mine's just one, this brown one, because it stands out in your hair and it's thin, so you can't really see it that much, but it's really really nice and holds everything up. And then I know this is going to sound a bit weird, but it is a brow comb, because this is really good for like little bits of hair that you want to back comb. You'll be seeing that a bit later. You'll also be needing one clip, because obviously you're going to be pulling bits out, and as you pull out the bun, bits fall out, and then you're going to want to like tight them all together. So you're going to be needing one of these, because I'll show you how to get it all together. You're going to be needing one of these brushes, which is one of the round ones that has bristles all the way around, one of the quite sharp ones, which, why did I just do that? I said it was sharp. And one of your ordinary flat paddle brushes. So that's everything that you're going to be needing, and because it's such hard work, you're going to be needing a tumbler with some juice in. As you can see, I've pretty much demolished mine, because I get so thirsty when I'm filming, I don't know why. But yeah, that's what you're going to be needing. Okay, so we're going to be getting started now. To begin the process to do this hairstyle, you're going to want to start by brushing your hair. The two brushes that I'm going to be using is this one. These are both by Primark. This one's from their Golden Glamour collection. Their hair collection is called Upia, I believe it is. That's what it says on there. And it's just their classic rounded paddle brush in black. And then from their silver blow dry collection, this one doesn't have a name because it doesn't have anything on the brush, it's just one of their rounded brushes, which we are going to be using for a bit of back combing. So obviously brushing your hair is quite simple. Some tips and tricks that I have learnt is to start from the bottom and work your way up. So start at the very bottom, and then I eventually start to put my hand behind it and work my way up to the very top, up to my root, and then do like a few brushes down. Then you're going to want to grab the section you just brushed, and from underneath just go from the bottom. Backcombing is quite, oh, don't get your hairbrush stuck though. Backcombing is quite self-explanatory. You just do a few little rubs and there you go. So you have a bit of volume, which is going to make doing your bun easier. I'll do again on this side, and then we will continue in fast motion. So like I said, start from the bottom, and then I eventually put my hand behind it, work your way up to the root, and then you're done. And then back comb, so grab the section. Ooh, do, do. Also, you could just like do a bit of zhuzhing. I don't know the name for it, so I just call it zhuzhing. And then as you go on top, I forgot to do it on this side, so you might just want to do a few at the beginning. And there you go, so you have some nice volume. Now let's just do this side. There we go, and then a few on the top, brush it down, and then you have some voluminous curl or volume in your hair. So as you can see now, I have a lot of volume in my hair. It doesn't matter if it looks messy because we are going to get started in doing the bun now. So you're going to want to grab your toggle or your hairband, I call it a toggle, and you're going to want to take your paddle brush and first of all scoop back only, this bit only, this section of your hair. Okay, now for this bit, so when you want to do a messy bun, it's better to have slightly greasier hair, like just a little bit of greasy in it, or grease in it, because then it will stay in the position that you want it to, and it's a lot easier to put up. So then, the next step, sorry, that was just a random like tip for you. So once you've done the, that, then you're going to want to take little bits from each section, just using your hands, and pull them up. It's just because sometimes for me this bit goes a bit bumpy, and from experimenting with previous times I've done this messy bun, it's been easier to brush the front. Okay, so now we have it all scooped back into a ponytail. Now I'm just gonna let it loosen a bit, like so, and then you're left with this, which is your ponytail. It should be really messy and scruffy. It shouldn't be perfect at all. Then you're gonna want to loosen the grip with a circular motion around your fingers and very gently pull your bun, or pull the ponytail into a bun. And then secure it with your hairband. Okay, so this is what your bun looks like. In the next part, I will show you how to zhuzh it up and make it look nice. Okay, so at the moment, it looks quite fleeky. We don't want it to look on fleek. Well, we do in a messy style. So at the moment, it's on fleek in a very posh way. Now, I quite, well, not posh, but quite sophisticated way. I'm quite impressed with my bun because it's quite big, but I'm just gonna pull it out a teeny bit, like so. There we go. And then I'm just going to pull or tug a bit on these sections so it makes it look looser. And then these sections here, I like to pull out like big sections of hair and little bits of my baby hairs. So for that, and then the same on the other side, like so. And then another trick that I have seen on YouTube that a lot of people do is backcombing. Now I thought it would be a great idea for little sections of hair to backcomb with one of these, which is your just everyday brow comb. I'm going to be using this end, which is like the bristly end, and I'm going to backcomb like we did with the other brush, but like, or obviously could talk then, with like a smaller brush. And then you can shape it. I like to twist mine a bit and then like ruffle it. And then, if you brush it through with your comb, or the comb on the other end, then I like to tuck it behind my ear, but keep this bit out front and do the same with the other side. I'm not gonna speed this bit up because it's not, doesn't take that long. Keep this bit out, tuck that behind my ear, and there we have it. So then, I'm just gonna tug on this bit around the back. Now if you do have any loose hairs that you want to secure in your bun, then obviously take your clip, pop it in, and voila, you have your messy bun. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to give it a thumbs up. And if you recreate this style, then post it on Instagram or Snapchat and use the hashtag RealMMaryMessyBun. It's a cool tag, I know. It's really not, it's so boring, but I couldn't think of anything else on the spot. But yes, make sure you keep subscribing. Thank you so much for 15 subscribers as well. I keep on forgetting to thank you guys. Thank you so much for 15 subscribers. It means so much to me. And yeah, I love you all very much. Bye.